This is Oliver Slope with Blue Line Futures coming to you from the floor of the CME here in Chicago with your grain market update. We are through the dreadful holiday trade and getting a little bit more participation, which means a little bit more volume. And we look for volume to confirm price. So we are moving higher with more volume, which is confirmation in our minds and very promising here for the near term, looking to the buy side and basically across the board, corn, soybeans, and wheat. But let's first start looking at the corn contract. March is the month of interest. 377 to 379 and a half has been our resistance pocket here. This represents the 50 and 100 day moving average, a key retracement on the year, as well as the original breakdown point from December 20th. If the bulls can chew through this pocket, I think the funds step in and extend their net long position and could potentially put us another 10 cents higher. That's about 386 to 387 would be the next target. Now on the support side of things, a failure to break out would probably take us towards the lower end of the recent range, 371 to 372. This is a must-hold area for the bulls. Now, moving over to the soybean market, March, again, the month of interest, $9 is that psychologically significant area, also represents the 50-day moving average. We think there's more upside to this market, with the objective being about 921 and three quarters to 925. This represents a key Fibonacci, as well as previously important price points. There has not been a whole lot of new news, but we suspect that China's likely stepping in and as a buyer in this market, and that news hasn't hit the wires. But again, price precedes news. So when that news does hit, maybe that's time to fade the rally. So that's what we're looking at for corn and soybeans. Wrapping things up with the wheat market, wheat trading higher as well. We held that psychologically significant $5 handle, caught a big pop here about an hour and a half ago this afternoon, and it wasn't a pop and drop. The pop was maintained, which I think is very good, but the bulls really want to see a close above 518 to 521 to wrap up the week. This was previous support and a breakdown point. If we can chew through that, I think we could see this market run 532 to 537. Now, lastly, one thing that we've been looking at is the Kansas City-Chicago spread. We were talking about that when that was about 24 cents wide. That has since narrowed to about 10 cents, so we still think there's opportunity there, but this probably isn't the place to step in, but certainly something you're going to want to keep on your radar here going forward through the month of January. So that's what we're looking at. That's what you should be looking at, too. This has been Oliver Slope with Blue Line Futures from the floor of the CME.